We know that has now been extended for the next 2 weeks as well. So how can life really look like after the lockdown is over? All of that you can find in today's newspapers as far as the Sunday Times is concerned. And let's get started with the Sunday Times, the Times of India, and the top headlines that it has this morning on the front page. So let's begin with this picture that Times of India has put out on the front page, where you can see people queuing up. And these are migrant workers in Mumbai's Dharavi who are jostling for travel forms that would enable them to take special trains back home. Railways operated at least a dozen Shramik specials on Saturday as states braced for a large influx. There were reports of violence in Gujarat, while one returning worker died in an accident in Odisha. And in Madhya Pradesh, meanwhile, 14 migrants were found squeezed into a cement mixer in a bid to reach UP from Maharashtra. And they have put this picture on the front page, which was the first thing that caught my attention this morning. And just see how people are wearing masks, but there is no social distancing because they all are in a hurry to reach back home, with the government now allowing some sort of special trains from some states. Another story that is very important and that is a headline on the front page is Delhi prepares to ease some curbs, but RWA is to have say. Remember, since day one, we've been telling you that how in Delhi, all the districts are red zones. So people were wondering as to what are the kind of relaxations that people in Delhi will be able to get. So now there are going to be some curbs. So it's a good news that Times of India has given us this morning. But it's the RWA, Resident Welfare Associations, which will have a say, which will be telling the people of Delhi as to which are the kind of relaxations that should be given at this point in time, should be feasible or not. And we'll take call on allowing plumbers and domestic help as well. So RWA are going to take a call on that. Another news that's important that is on the front page of Times of India, it says Lokpal member who tested COVID positive has died. Lokpal member, Justice retired Ajay Kumar Tripathi, who tested positive for COVID-19, died after suffering a cardiac arrest at AIIMS Trauma Center on Saturday. That's a sad news we've got this morning. On the other hand, some politics as well that's happening over Arogya app. Rahul Gandhi, Congress's MP from Wayanad, and Ravi Shankar Prasad, Union Minister, are sparring over Arogya app. That's another story that Times of India has got on the front page. What the story is all about, let's just give you a little more detail into that. After Rahul Gandhi on Saturday called Arogya Setu app a sophisticated surveillance system raising data security and privacy concerns, Union Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad has now hit back, saying that it had a robust data security architecture. So there is a war of words that's going on over the Arogya Setu app as well. Then very interesting, in fact, analysis has been done by Himanshi Dhawan and Madhav Chanchani talking about the lockdown blues and some interesting statistics these people have put out. More people are stepping out. We know there is a lockdown in place, but the data suggests that more people have been stepping out. Let's get into this article and get you more details. Well, it says that 47% drop in visits to grocery, medical shops in April, against 64% in March. 58% decline in office goers in April from 65% in the previous month. So according to Google Mobility Report, this is the analysis that they have done. And as far as Delhi's overall cases and India's overall corona cases are concerned, we saw biggest spurt in city, in the national capital, with 384 new cases. In India, the number of cases rose by 2,564. This is what Durgesh Nandan Jha has reported. And there is some good news as well that Times of India is reporting this morning on a possible drug for coronavirus. And this is Remdesivir. Now, US has given a nod to Remdesivir. It has started using it as well for some of its patients. And now India has also planned trials of this particular drug. The US Food and Drug Administration has allowed emergency use of antiviral drug Remdesivir, previously used for Ebola to treat COVID-19. COVID-19 patients. India is looking to import the drug to kickstart local trials. Very, very interesting piece of information, as the number of cases in India are now inching close to 40,000 mark. So this is another thing that we can look forward to. Meanwhile, there are a couple of other interesting stories as well on the front page. Forces have lost contact with combat team during a JNK gunfight that was going on till late last night. We'll be bringing you a fresh update on this in just a bit. Then there could be some relief for people who have EMIs, monthly EMIs going, because banks may let you defer EMIs for 3 more months. That's another story that Times of India has reported on the front page. Prime Minister and Finance Minister Mull boost to financial sector and SMEs. That is another thing that we are looking forward to. And lastly, before we go across to Navbharat Times and get you the headlines from there, some sort of a relief for Indians in America. U.S. relief for H-1B visa holders is something that is there. The U.S. has given a grace period of 60 days to H-1B visa holders and green card applicants. So some good news out there. So that's how the front page of Times of India looks like. Let's now get you the latest as far as Navbharat Times is concerned. Or Navbharat Times ki agar baat kare, to pehli khabar jo aaj front page pe Navbharat Times ne lagai hai, wo hai ki Delhi mein CRPF ke 71 jawanon mein corona, एक ही इमारत में 41 मरीज पाए गए हैं. ये एक बहुत ही अहम खबर है और क्रिटिकल भी है कि इस तरह से क्या हुआ, क्या वजह थी कि 71 जवानों में कोरोना वायरस जो है पॉजिटिव पाया गया है, और इसी के चलते दिल्ली में जो है 384 मरीज एक ही दिन के अंदर पाए गए हैं. इट इज़ अ बिग कॉज ऑफ कंसर्न. इसके अलावा चीफ मिनिस्टर अरविंद केजरीवाल ने कहा है कि सील इलाके ही हो रेड जोन, दुकानें और इवन खुले. तो जहां एमएचए ने गाइडलाइंस दी हैं, जिसमें देश को 3 हिस्सों में बांटा गया है, डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स को रेड, ऑरेंज और ग्रीन जोन, चीफ मिनिस्टर अरविंद केजरीवाल का कहना है कि रेड जोन में जो सील इलाके हैं वहां पर ही शायद एक्टिविटीज को अभी बंद रखना चाहिए, लेकिन दुकानें जो हैं उन्हें ऑड इवन के फॉर्मूला से खोलना शुरू कर देना चाहिए. और साथ ही एक और खबर है, फंस गए हैं दिल्ली में, यह है आपकी घर वापसी का तरीका. पूरी जानकारी इसमें दी हुई है. अगर आप राजधानी में फंसे दूसरे राज्यों के लोगों को घर पहुंचाने के लिए दिल्ली सरकार ने इंतजाम शुरू कर दिए हैं. शेल्टर होम में रह रहे 15,000 मजदूरों में से 7,000 के बीच सर्वे हो चुका है. तो किस तरह से सरकार कोशिश कर रही है यहां पर फंसे लोगों को वापस ले जाने की, वो एक और खबर है नवभारत टाइम्स में. और लेट्स नाउ टॉक अबाउट द इकोनॉमिक टाइम्स, द पिंक पेपर, एज वी bring to you on a daily basis. Today on Sunday, it's a Economic Times magazine that has come out, wherein you can see on the front page it says the great reopening. As the economy reboots gradually starting tomorrow, we will likely see a cost-conscious consumer gravitating towards certain aisles in the great Indian bazaar. So this magazine is very interesting, because I was going through it during the break, and I found that how here various articles are there which give you a sense as to how the consumer behavior is going to perhaps change after the activities begin from tomorrow onwards. It also has got an interview with Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan, who says that the government is mulling increasing work day from 8 hours now to 10 or 12 hours. The entire interview is published here in this the Economic Times magazines that you can get. Here there is an article which says that how India has changed its media consumption habits and virtual behavior since the lockdown kicked in. Some of these might be here to stay, and very interesting graphs which give you a sense as to how the viewing of television by Indian consumer has really changed in this last period of lockdown that we have seen. Apart from that, there is another article on the great reopening, wherein the kind of consumer behavior one can expect after the lockdown is over. And they have given a comparison as well, that how China witnessed the curious phenomena of revenge shopping after lockdown, because people were not able to shop anything when they were in lockdown, and once the lockdown was lifted, these are the kind of scenes that were witnessed in parts of China. Let's focus on this picture that they have put out, number of people, and this is an article that they have compared the Indian condition with. So like this, you've got a lot of interesting articles to read this Sunday. And before we go across to the city edition very quickly. As far as Swaminomics is concerned, which is a regular feature on Sunday, there is an interesting article that has been written by Swaminathan Iyer that you can also read this Sunday as far as the impact of lockdown is concerned. And that can also help you understand that how lockdown is going to have an impact on the lives of people as well. So this is the article I'm talking about, Shutdown Skill 2, Let Business Get Back on Track, an article by Swaminathan Iyer, something that you will really enjoy reading this Sunday. Moving on now to the city editions, and let's begin with the National Capital. And Mohit Sharma, my colleague, is now joining us. Okay, we have Sharon joining us on the broadcast. More on this. Sharon, good morning. Can you explain to us what kind of relaxations are being planned for the National Capital? Because the front page has got a story, says that Delhi prepares to ease some curbs, but RWA is to have say. So what kind of relaxations can the people of Delhi really expect?
Good morning, Hina. This comes as a positive news for the people of Delhi that Arvind Kejriwal government has in fact decided that they are going to in fact implement all the guidelines that has been put forth by the Ministry of Home Affairs as far as the red zone is concerned. Now, there are 11 districts in Delhi and all of them are in red zone. And all in all these districts, there are containment zones. Overall, there are 97 containment zones. So no activities are going to be in those 97 containment zones. But there are going to be activities, there is going to be a push to the economic activities in the red zones. But if you want your domestic health, plumber, electrician to come to your society, that depends on the Resident Welfare Association. They have to approve it, and then only the domestic help, the plumber, electrician, for any sort of such work, the government has given the responsibility to the RWA to decide whether they are going to allow these people inside the society or not. So it merely depends on them. But other than that, the activities in red zones include that people can now ply on a road, but there has to be two people in the car, one person on two-wheeler. There are going to be private companies that are going to work, but with only 33% right. staff. Senior government officials have to be are going to be in offices. So there are certain relaxations that has been given in red zone. More relaxation could come in place once Arvind Kejriwal government speak to the center, because they want certain relaxation, more relaxation in red zone. They want the red zone to have more activities, because there are no green zone, no orange zone in National Capital. So it becomes right. very important there is some sort of a economic push in the red zone.
All right, Sharon, thank you very much for the moment for joining us with all of those details from the National Capital. Shifting focus now to the Mumbai edition of Times of India. And on the front page, it says that state stays firm, no easing of lockdown for Mumbai and Pune. Arunil, my colleague, is joining us on the broadcast more on this. Arunil, good morning. Clearly, one thing is there that for Mumbai and Pune, there are going to be no relaxations because these two are the hot zones in Maharashtra.
Well, that is right, Hina. In fact, the situation still remains precarious, especially in the red zones in the state of Maharashtra. 14 red zones are there in the state of Maharashtra, because yesterday recorded the highest spike in a day with respect to number of deaths in the state of Maharashtra, as well as the same was the condition in the city of Mumbai as well. 36 deaths were recorded in the state of Maharashtra. 27 deaths were recorded in the financial capital of the country, that is the city of Mumbai. So the situation remains very precarious. And because of that, the lockdown measures are not similar to what that have been implemented in Delhi. Here, the lockdown are more stringent, and with respect to 30% offices to be 30% staff to be allowed to go to offices, that has been completely negated. Ajay Mehta, the chief secretary, has said right. that we won't allow that, at least at present. We will be looking at how things are after around 10 days, and probably after that, okay. around 10% of the staff may be allowed to attend office if they are able to travel in right. their own car. similar kind of measures have been taken with respect to red zones.
All right. Thank you, Arunil, for the moment for joining us with all of those details. We are now moving on to the Chennai edition of Times of India. And here we have seen some relaxations coming. And this is what Chennai edition of Times of India has talked about. It says city opens for business, all shops to work 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. from Monday. Let's go across to my colleague Shabir joining us on the broadcast for more on this. Shabir, good morning. Now, at the same time, it is being reported that a new high as 99 die in one day. Fresh cases have crossed 2,500 in Tamil Nadu. Can you give us more details?
Well, there are more and more cases being reported in the city of Chennai. And, the cases, the number of cases that have, has reached more than 2,800. So it's clear that, these relaxations are only for non-containment zones. Yesterday, the cabinet, was discussing about relaxations for more than 3 hours. And what we understand is that after careful consideration and looking at the situation, reviewing the situation, they have decided that certain relaxations will be given, and that will be for non-containment zones. As far as industry establishments are concerned, the special economic zones, export units, IT and IT-enabled services will operate all across the state. As far as the IT industry is concerned, they have said that they have to operate with 10% of workforce, minimum 20 employees. And there have been certain guidelines that have been issued to industries in rural areas. At least they can operate with 50% of manpower. As far as the city of Chennai is concerned, they have made certain rules and certain with certain caveats. Some institutions have been allowed to function, and that is also because of the number of cases that Chennai has been reported. Chennai has been seeing a huge spike in the number of positive cases.
All right.
For the past 4 to 5 days, we have reported more than 500 cases.
All right. Thank you very much, Shabir, for the moment for joining us with all of those details. We're now moving on to the Kolkata edition of the Times of India today. And the big news that they are reporting today is governor attacks unprecedented, unparalleled, says Mamata Banerjee, the chief minister of West Bengal. Let's go across to my colleague Shreyasi joining us on the broadcast. So we're on there. Shreyasi, now what's happening between the governor and the chief minister is the top story today. Could you just quickly tell us what happened in the last 24 hours?
Well, Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee went on to respond to the governor, the letters that he had written on the 23rd and 24th of April. And thereafter, of course, the 13-page long letter that the Chief Minister has shot off to Raj Bhavan went on to say how the tone and the tenor of this letter was unacceptable. And at a time when the government is fighting against the COVID outbreak, Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has said the attack that has come in from the governor has been unprecedented. Of course, this letter comes in at a time where the governor has been alleging there is no transparency in the COVID data that is being released by the state, and also raising questions on the public distribution system here in West Bengal.
All right. Thank you very much, Shreyasi, for the moment for joining us with all of those details. We are now moving on from Kolkata to the latest we are getting from Bengaluru edition of the Times of India. And on the front page, the story that it's leading with today is Lockdown 3.0. Karnataka wants relaxed within Bengaluru as well. That's the big focus that they have today. Let's go across to my colleague Deepak Bopanna joining us on the broadcast for more on this. Deepak, now Karnataka will be seeking centers not to limit the red areas. What exactly are going to be these red areas in Karnataka? Are they same as the ones in red zones or different?
Yes, that's what they're talking about. We can understand that we speculated this on the day that the Ministry of Health, designated Bengaluru, rural Bengaluru, urban and Mysuru as the red zones, which meant that, one of the most commercially viable districts in Karnataka, which could be a major contributor to the economy, if that is the criteria here of easing relaxations of the lockdown, if they are put in the red zones, most of the economic activity would take a hit here. They say that, in the orange zones and the green zones, cats can operate and, you know, Red Bull cats operate. So where is the question of having cats if the Bengaluru cannot operate? That is where the state government is taking the request to compartmentalize a red zone like Bengaluru into smaller pockets so that you...
So we'll see how the government will have to respond to that, how the center will respond to this request. Thank you very much, Deepak, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. We're now moving on to the news that we are getting for you from around the world. H-1B visa holders and green card applicants get 60-day breather. That's the big news that has come, a big relief as well. And apart from that, one more interesting story. Kim resurfaces after 20 days of absence. And that's a picture as well the Times of India has put. North Korea's state news agency released a photo of Kim Jong-un, which it said was taken on Friday at a fertilizer plant. His sister is in the background. There you can see her. And let's get you the latest from the world of sports as well. And the most important story today is Shami, fast bowler Mohammad Shami, has revealed that he contemplated suicide thrice in the time that he was recovering from an injury. Let's go across to my colleague Karishma, joining us on the broadcast when we're on this. Karishma, good morning. This is quite shocking news and a sad news as well that we are getting, that Mohammad Shami thought of committing suicide thrice.
Well, yes, good morning to you, Hina, and to all the viewers. This is a sad and shocking news that has that we have come across, that Mohammad Shami in an Instagram live chat revealed that he contemplated suicide in 2015. One, because he played with a fractured knee throughout the 2015 World Cup. There was a time when he wouldn't be able to walk after matches, and he was playing throughout the 2015 semi-finals with painkillers. Then there was this whole issue about his family problems, the wife filing the case, and he was fighting his custody battles. That all of that took a toll on him. And then just before IPL, he had an accident, he had a head injury, right, which all put together, made him contemplate suicide in 2015. It took him 18 months to come back into the national team, and that is why Mohammad Shami did not have...
So Mohammad Shami revealing some dark moments of his life. Thank you very much, Karishma, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. We're now moving on to the latest that our viewers today can see as far as the Delhi Times edition is concerned. And today, I want to begin with the Mask India Challenge that Times of India has. And in the Mask India Challenge, let me just show it to you from here only. And Mask India Challenge, and this is what I want to focus on. You have been asked to share a picture of yours wearing a homemade mask, and this is how we are featuring the best pictures on the Delhi Times page. And there are three here as well that our viewers had sent over the last couple of days. Apart from this, there is an article on Chef Vikas Khanna. Vendors stood for hours to feed us. Can't let them go hungry. In fact, the chef is donating essentials like rice, atta, dal, and sanitary pads to NGOs, old age homes, individuals and groups. And this is an article that has come. And singers have created an anthem for Corona Warriors. That's another story that Delhi Times has got today. Plus, something that the Avengers fan can look forward to. Avengers have assembled for coronavirus relief. That's another story that you can find on the Delhi Times this Sunday. With this, it's a wrap on the newspaper show. We'll be back tomorrow morning again, same time. Thanks for watching.
With over 18 years of experience.
What I love about interviews is finding out what the person is trying to not tell me. Reading between the lines.
Tamanna Inamdar is objective.